Hi, I'm James Deaker, formerly an advertising executive at Yahoo, Verizon Media, and Oath. I also have a Stanford PhD in Engineering Economic Systems and Operations Research. Today, I'm going to be defining yield management and revenue management and talking about why it's applicable to digital media and how that is different than for the airline and hotel industries. And to add further clarity for the scope of this video, I'm going to be talking about display ads on phones, laptops, and tablets. Let's get going. The original source of yield management was the airlines. Traditionally, they were trying to work out how to fly their planes full. A term you might hear is load factor. This is simply the ratio of the number of seats on the plane to how many are being used on a particular flight. The airlines would use techniques like overbooking and timing discounts to try to optimize the number of people on each flight. In this sense, the initial focus was very much on inventory, where in this case, the inventory is the number of seats that are being used on each plane. Because planes are expensive to fly, a lot of the attention early in the industry was how to fly the planes full. Over time, there came to be much more attention on the price that was commanded by those tickets, and that was when the term yield management came into common usage. Finally, the term revenue management was used to describe the combination of both pricing and inventory dynamics. The problem is obviously very similar in the hotel industry, where in that case, the inventory is the number of hotel rooms that is available. As a formal practice, yield management is relatively young. The first academic articles didn't appear until the 1980s. Now let's look at the common conditions that are necessary for a problem to fall into the space of yield management or revenue management. Here's the Wikipedia definition. Yield management, also known as revenue management, is the process of understanding, anticipating, and influencing consumer behavior in order to maximize revenue or profits from a fixed perishable resource. There are three conditions for it to be applicable: fixed amount of resources, the resources are perishable, and different customers are willing to pay a different price for using the same amount of resources. So let's look at the airlines and then compare that against digital media. So we've talked about how in airlines, when they first started trying to solve some of these problems, they looked at load factor, selling as many seats as possible, and they were less concerned about price. Over time, price became more of a focus and turned into yield management. And finally, revenue management takes account of both the price and inventory dynamics. And I acknowledge that I'm being a little bit simplistic in the sequencing of how these events came apart, but for our purposes, this works. So now let's compare against digital media. In digital media, the equivalent of seats are the number of impressions that are sold. The digital media equivalent is let's try to sell out all the ads on a page and make sure that we're not running any house ads. The equivalent of price for the airline industry in digital media is the sold eCPM. So effectively, what is the pricing from the ads that we're getting on each of the pages? And of course, what we want to focus on is the optimal revenue that we get from the cross combination of maximizing the impressions and the price sold for those. And so as we can see, we end up in a situation where revenue management is looking at how do we get the most revenue from the cross combination of the impressions that we have available on our pages and the price. And that is what we should be trying to maximize. The IAB is the industry body associated with interactive advertising. And their definition, which I helped craft, was that yield and revenue management for this industry is the process of understanding, anticipating, and influencing advertiser and consumer behavior to maximize profits through better selling, pricing, packaging, inventory management, while delivering advertisers and site users value. Now, one of the things you'll notice is this is a slightly broader definition than the one from Wikipedia. It also places focus on the dynamics of both the advertisers who are going to be buying the ads on the pages, but also consumer behavior, in this sense, the consumer being the user who will go to the web page or the app, because how those users engage with the page informs how many impressions are available, and it informs how much the publisher can monetize each of the different engagement sessions. So now we're getting into the differences, because there are some significant differences. Even though we may hear the terms thrown about revenue management for both airlines and digital media, in practice, there are significant differences. I'm going to read through the airline and then look at the digital media on the right-hand side of the slide. In airlines, the products are essentially how many trips that you can take. Where, if you're trying to book a flight from San Francisco to New York, you may have many different options, including layovers in different cities across the US, but realistically, the number of options that you might choose are limited. Also, as a consumer, I'm realistically only going to buy a small number of products. I might buy a flight for myself or my family, but it is likely going to be a handful of products. The digital media equivalent is that there are literally millions of different products that are available for sale. As we've talked about in some of the other videos that I've created, what we can have is different publishers can create products. Even within one publisher, there are many different locations on their website or within their app that are available for sale. And when you layer in the different types of audience and demographic targeting, you end up with thousands or potentially millions of different products that are available for sale. The other thing that's important to think about is the impact of price. When the airlines increase or decrease their pricing, assuming that the consumer doesn't go to the competition, there can be a relatively straightforward relationship between price and revenue because the consumer is still going to perhaps buy a given unit of inventory. In this case, the unit would be the trip across the country. However, in digital media, budgets are fixed. So, for example, an advertiser might have a $1 million campaign. So, if the price decreases, it's not necessarily clear that that's going to translate into the advertiser immediately increasing their budget and spending more money. They may simply generate more impressions. The other dynamic that's important when we contrast airlines with digital media is the price response. In airlines, the least price sensitive customer is the business traveler, and they're going to book last. In the case of digital media, the most price sensitive customers tend to be direct marketers, who are the ones who are trying to buy clicks or buy the consumer clicking through to their site. And they tend to book last rather than first, basically sucking up the remnant inventory that's available. Then a final distinction is the sales channel. And this is becoming less relevant now, but certainly circa 2010 and even through circa 2015, airlines had moved very much automated, whereas much of the buying in digital media was still hand-sold by a sales team. That is less true now in 2023, but still we're in a situation where sales teams play a significant role, and because it is relationship-based, it's significantly harder to move the price into the digital media. So let's summarize. When we think about the components of revenue management in digital media, there are a host of different components. It can involve things as straightforward as price setting, so setting up your rate card and changing the prices on it. If it's programmatic buying, you need to think about auction management, so the rules and setting the floor prices within the auction. It involves inventory management and inventory forecasting, potentially the creation of new ad units on your page or adding units to existing pages. It involves the rules around loading ad, or this could sometimes be referred to as ad rotation, where we have an ad that loads on the page. If the consumer stays on that page, then what we may see is that after 20, 30, or 40 seconds, the ad may get swapped out for a different ad. The revenue management team needs to think about advertiser incentives, sales incentives. They need to think about how to structure buyer annual deals and structure buyer preferences. And so, in other words, there are a host of different tactics that the revenue management team within a digital publisher needs to be aware of and needs to have as part of their scope and purview. I hope this was an interesting and useful overview of some of the contrasts between revenue management within digital media and with compared to the airline industry. Thanks a lot.